Are you excited to be at MCM London Comic Con and meet the fans here?
Absolutely. I was just explaining to someone that probably over the past 20 years, I've done maybe less than a dozen. If this is my second this year, maybe I've only done three in the past few years, maybe one every other year. And each one is different. Each one is, I'm always fascinated. I was just in Indianapolis and I was fascinated by, I did this very odd film and it's the weirdest film. I'll put this down on camera. The weirdest film ever made called The Killer Tongue. I did it with Robert Englund, Doug Bradley. It was all produced British. We shot it in Spain in 96. The costumes were done at Pinewood. And it's just this very obscure, strange, literally the weirdest movie ever made. And in Indianapolis, of all places, that was the most popular film of people. I purposely showed up to this convention because of this film. And I don't even own it. I don't even know how to get it. But, you know, I started doing maybe a Xena convention. And then, and a lot of people like The Return of the Living Dead 3. But then some people, you know, it's gone beyond just comic books and sci-fi and horror. It's The OC or Nikita. And everyone has a different story of why they like that. And I think that we're really in this amazing time period of in the heyday of this of these conventions and there're hundreds going on all over the world on any given weekend, and I hope we get to ride this train a little bit because it's really rewarding to meet all kinds of different people all over the world, and they happen to like Firefly or they like this obscure movie that you did, or they got a kick out of Entourage, you know. So all things that I loved and been proud to do. And this is such nice weather here for me. It's been triple digits in LA all summer. So yeah, I'm happy to be here. Well, I'm more than others, possibly. I mean, I can't speak for other cast members or people in general, but number one, I actually was born and grew up. Well, I was born in Southern California, but I grew up in Dana Point, and I grew up in Orange County. We didn't call it the OC; that was a Josh Schwartz situation. But it was just a blast to be part of something. You know, I came from doing a lot of genre things, like whether it was Star Trek or if it was Lady Heather, the dominatrix, or Nandy, the horror with the heart of gold, you know. But to play something that ultimately developed into a dramedy, and every day I got to go to work, and they started writing for the character, and that's the beauty about television, is we shoot for 10 months, and it's my job to show up and say the dialogue the way it's been written, and then maybe add a little bit something else to it so that the writers are inspired to write for me, the actor, and thus I keep my job. So you have to, the advice I give to young actors is don't miss the opportunity to take risks every day that you go to work, especially if you're on a television show. These writers have to be inspired to write possibly one season to 10 seasons. Unfortunately, I think the OC could have gone and would have liked to have it gone longer than 4 seasons. That and Lady Heather are my favorite roles, just for totally completely different reasons. But the OC was kind of my daughter was 3 at the time. She's now 18. Oh, and by the way, she refused to ever watch it. She watched Gossip Girl and Vampire Diaries and Pretty Little Things, and she only started watching the OC just now, and she loves it. And I said, well, why didn't you watch it before? She said, because I didn't want to watch my mom making out with teenagers. And I said, I was only 32, and, you know, they were 25 or 27, and it's acting. But she's, it was such good writing, and it was so original. And when the show finished, I realized people kept asking me if it was really like the OC or Orange County. And I said, You know what's interesting is I realized for every script that I read, I could come up with a story that was just the same, if not worse. Or I had a friend who actually got drunk, fell off a cliff, and died. And that happened to Johnny. Or, you know, friends that had died in car accidents, like Marissa. So it was really a bizarre experience for me. But I miss it. I really do miss it. And, you know, there's been all these reunions of television shows happening, and people talk about it. It would be a blast. I don't know if it could ever happen, but, you know. But yes, it did define quite a few kids' high school lives, those 4 years. I was a freshman when it started, and I'm a senior, or college.
Do you think it could come back, though?
Absolutely. I don't see why not. But, you know, I can think of a few people that might not want to do it, but I wouldn't name names.